Hello everyone. In this video, I am going to be testing this 1/10 scale rock crawler featuring a custom 3D printed ladder frame, and I'm going to be adding panel lines to this Jeep Cherokee body. But first, I want to talk a little about this project. About a week and a half ago, I decided I wanted to build a basic custom 1/10 scale rock crawler. So I ordered these aluminum axles and transmission off of eBay and began designing a simple ladder frame with mounts for the transmission, electronics, and suspension. I 3D printed all of the necessary parts and I 3D printed the frame rails, but initially just for the purpose of using them to build a mock-up of the chassis so I can make sure everything fits. I planned on using 3mm thick stainless steel to make the two frame rails. However, with the mock-up chassis all together and everything mounted, I wanted to test how the ABS plastic 3D printed two-piece, due to my printer's limited build area, frame rails hold up, and get an early idea of how the crawler performs and what design changes I can make to improve the performance. So I mounted some basic electronics and tires I had sitting around, and put this ProLine Jeep Cherokee body on top to make this crawler complete. So for the sake of convenience, I decided to just set up some obstacles using stuff lying around in the garage, instead of going out into a wooded area, since I just wanted to do some basic testing and I wasn't sure how well the crawler was going to hold up. But thankfully, the crawler worked great and I didn't have any issues while driving. And even with it being slightly underpowered, especially with this steering servo, the crawler performed pretty decently. However, one thing I noticed right away while driving was the poor turning radius, which I believe is a combination of the wheel simply not turning very sharp, but more significantly because of the anti-Ackerman steering angle combined with a locked diff, which is causing a lot of wheel slip when turning, especially on hard, flat surfaces. As I mentioned earlier, I ordered these axles from eBay, so they aren't my design, but I'm still going to see if there's anything I can do to help improve the steering angle. Ideally, I think a Pro Ackerman or even a parallel steering angle would work much better, but I'm not sure if there's an easy way to make that possible with these axles. Plus, I'm going to install a little longer arm onto the servo, so that should help the steering as well. Well, let's talk about the frame. So the question I had was, how sturdy is this completely plastic, minus the hardware, 3D printed ladder frame going to be? As expected, the frame rails do flex quite a bit. I'll give a demonstration of how much flex there is in the frame a little later on in this video. But there is definitely a noticeable amount of chassis flex, particularly right here where opposite wheels are up on the bricks. There's quite a bit of frame twist. It's a little hard to tell from this angle, but again, I'm going to demonstrate the chassis flex later on. Obviously, substituting a 3mm thick steel part with an identically designed 3mm ABS plastic part comes with some sacrifices in the rigidity of the frame. And just for anyone who's curious, the frame rails as well as some of the cross members were printed with a 100% infill, or in other words, they are completely solid. But with that said, having a frame with some twist, even as significant as with this vehicle, isn't necessarily a bad thing as far as crawling is concerned. The bigger concern for me is the durability of the chassis. Obviously, using metal frame rails would significantly increase the strength and durability of the ladder frame assembly. But just from handling the frame and the little testing I've done so far, I can't imagine any part of the frame breaking during typical rock crawling, trail driving, mud bogging, etc. But with the minimal amount of driving I've done so far, it's hard to say for sure what the breaking point is. But in short, the 3D printed ladder frame, when equipped with basic lower power electronics, seems sturdy enough for general trail driving and crawling, comparable to what you would do with a stock or lightly modified SCX-10 or similar vehicle. However, the frame is far more flexible than any conventional steel frame chassis, but is still strong enough to take some abuse. So I want to show you how much this chassis flexes. It is pretty durable, but far more bendy than what I want. One simple thing I might try to stiffen the chassis is to make the frame rails a little thicker. Right now they are 3mm thick. Also, I might try printing them in a more rigid material like PLA just to see if that makes a significant difference. So the other part of this project is working on the body. This is a ProLine Racing Jeep Cherokee body. I got this over a year ago as a part of a trade, already cut and painted. Now I'm finally getting around to using it. The paint job is pretty mediocre, but I really like the color. Especially in the sun, the paint has a great look to it. I wanted to do some things to help improve the appearance by adding some detail and accessories to the body. I decided to start by adding panel lines. Since the body has already been painted, my only option is to draw or paint the lines on the outside of the body. Unfortunately, I was all out of the tape I like to use for panel lines, so I decided to use some other masking tape to mark the lines and spray them black. The lines didn't really turn out exactly how I wanted them to. I wasn't getting a good spray with this paint, and probably as a result of that, the paint bled through the tape in some spots. Masking the lines and then painting over them is one way to get clean, straight panel lines. However, it's a bit time-consuming, and I didn't really want to invest that much time into this body. So I began using a detail pen and ran it along the tape. This was a bit tricky because the thin ink could easily get under the tape, causing the lines to not have a clean edge. So in the end, I just freehanded most of the lines. I'm not thrilled with the result, but it is a body I intend to bash around with, so there's no point in making it perfect. But that is all for this video. I will continue to mess around with this chassis and see what improvements I can make, as well as add some more details to the body. I do plan on lowering it some. The body mounts on it right now are just temporary. I think the body looks like it's sitting a little too high up on the chassis right now. I also want to add some inner fenders, windshield wipers, exhaust, maybe a roof rack, and some other stuff to make it look more scale. I do plan on making the STL files for this chassis available for anyone to download and print once I'm a little further along in the design process. Right now, there are a lot of things that need to be changed and improved on this chassis. I'll be posting more updates on this project, as well as other cool stuff I'm building, and making it a point to release at least one video every week. So thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, I would appreciate it if you hit the like button, subscribe, leave a comment, and share. I'm new to making videos, and I want to try and grow this channel and create as high quality of content as possible, and your support as well as constructive criticism is all appreciated. I hope you have a great day, and I'll see you next time.